This video is taken for the ECOF major selection interview. Each year in the interviews, you will be asked to do a math test and then verbal interviews. And in the math examinations, usually they will ask for some simple mathematic knowledge. For example, in your math 103, 1013, or 1023, you learn about the limit and differentiation. So they will test whether you can apply the math concept into economics. And it won't be difficult because, frankly speaking, the year one students should not are not expected to learn so much about mathematics. Therefore, you just have to do some review about what you have learned in the past. So in the examination, usually they will ask three main topics. The first one is the limits. The second one is the differentiation, the basic derivatives. And finally is the application of the differentiation. Sometimes they will ask for some special topics such as matrix. And in this case, you better study all of them before you go to the interviews. So let's begin. Let's talk about the limit. First, you have to know sevenths of the rule of the limits. First is the sum rule. The limit x goes to a of fx plus gx is equal to the limit of x goes to a of fx plus limit of x goes to a of gx. And the minus is the similar logic. And here, c is the constant. Limit of x approach to a of c times fx. You can take out the constant first, then times the limit of fx. And this is the product properties. Limit of x approach to a of fx times gx. Then you can just do the limit of the separate function first, then multiply it together. This is the quotient. Limit of x approach to a of fx derived by gx. You can just, again, do the limit of fx and gx independently, then do the divisions, providing that the denominator cannot be zero. If the denominator is zero, you can do some adjustment, and later we will see how to find the limit. And f and g are some special properties. So usually in the test, they will ask you to evaluate the limit. For example, you will be given some polynomial. Here, px is 7x cubed plus 3x squared plus 4x plus 2, and you are asked to evaluate the limit when x approaches to a. Well, the easiest way is to do direct substitutions. Here, there are no divisions, no denominators. Therefore, you can rule out this case. You don't have to care about whether the denominator is equal to zero. Therefore, if you direct substitute x to be a, what you will get is, you direct substitute x to be a plus 3a squared plus 4a plus 2. And this will be your answer. So it won't be very, very difficult. And sometimes you won't be given that simple result. You will be given some number and asked to calculate the exact value. For example, let's take a look at these two examples. For the first one, you are asked to evaluate the x approach to 2 and the function, what will it become by applying the direct substitution. Okay, before you apply the direct substitution, first, check whether the denominator approach is equal to 0. So if you substitute x to be 2 here, then the denominator become 40 minus 36. This is equal to 4, not equal to 0. Therefore, this is perfectly fine for you to apply the direct substitution method. So it will become 3 times 2 squared minus 4 times 2 derived by 5 times 2 to the power 3 minus 36. Then by direct substitution, you will get 3 times 4 minus 4 times 2 derived by 40, which is equal to 12 minus 8 divided by 40. And at the end, this is equal to 1 over 10. Okay, so here should be some typo. Okay, the denominator should be 4, and at the end this is equal to 1 only. Okay, so here you have to be careful. So make sure you have double check your answer before you submit your questions. Okay, so how about the second examples? Again, check whether the denominator becomes 0 first. So you can see when x approaches to 2, the denominator is equal to 5, is equal to 4 times 2 plus 1, this is equal to 9. So this is perfectly fine to do the direct substitution. So the result is, okay, direct substitution. So the first one is equal to 25, take the square root, plus 6 minus 1 divided by 9. Okay, so the numerator will become 10 and the denominator is 9. Okay, so this is the result. Again, this method is not very difficult. So what's the more difficult is that, okay, what if x approach to something that making the denominator become 0? And if this case happens, you have to apply some trick to deal with the problems. So let's consider the next two examples. Okay, so here you can see that evaluate this limit. When x equal to 2, the denominator will become 4 minus 4 equal to 0. Therefore, in this case, you cannot apply the direct substitutions because you have to ensure that the denominator is not equal to 0. What you can do is that first, simplify the expressions. So, you can see both the numerator and denominator are some quadratic functions, quadratic equations. Therefore, you can simplify it first. The denominator can be simplified to be x minus 4 times x minus 2. And the denominator is x plus 2 times x minus 2. So in this case, this x minus 2 can be cancelled. So the things become easier, right? If you substitute x equal to 2 into this expression, you will get negative 2 divided by 4. This is negative 1/2. So this is the way how you deal with the problems with the denominator equal to 0. So again, in the interview questions, it won't be difficult because this is, well, economics is not all about mathematics. If you can use the basic stuff, you understand the basic stuff, then you are perfectly fine. Okay, so let's consider the more difficult one. Here, evaluate the limit of these functions. Again, if you put 1 to be x, you will find that the denominator becomes 0. So what you can do, the way you can deal with this problem is try to rationalize the expressions. For example, so always you have to use some trick to deal with this denominator be equal to 0 case. Okay, so you multiply both by square root of x plus 1. Therefore, in the numerator, you will get x plus square root x minus square root x minus 1, and the denominator is, keep it the same, you don't have to do anything. As a result, in the numerator, this can be cancelled and become x minus 1, and the denominator is x minus 1 times square root of x plus 1. Okay, so here you can see these two can be cancelled. What is remaining is this one. Okay, here if you substitute x equal to 1 into here, you are perfectly fine because the denominator is no longer 0, and the final answer is 1/2. Okay, so whenever you come across the problems that the denominator equal to zero, you should do some trick to deal with the problems. The last part of the topic maybe asks you to evaluate the limit when the value approaches to infinities. Again, this is sometimes useful in economics, in higher level economics. You are asked to evaluate whether the, for example, the growth of GDP approaches to zero or keep on increasing or in an increasing rate when time goes to infinity. Therefore, you may be asked to evaluate the limit when the value goes to infinity. So here are some of the basic rules. You don't have to know all of them. You just need to analyze what will be the value when the x or n or t become very large. Okay, so let's just introduce some. Okay, if the power is even, the limit of x approach to positive or negative infinity is equal to infinity. This is because if you draw the function for the square one, maybe the shape is like this. For the power 4, maybe like this. Okay, so as long as this is even number, the power is even, they will approach to infinity when x become large. Okay, so the counterpart is when n is odd. So if n is odd, the function will be similar to like this, similar to this. Okay, so this may be power 3, this may be power 5. Okay, so you can see when x is positive, it becomes positive infinity. When x is negative, it becomes negative infinity. For the third one, if the denominator becomes greater and greater, so one derived by the greater and greater denominator will approach to zero. So this is the basic rules. Okay. So if you are asked to evaluate the limit as x goes to infinity, what you can do is, okay, you just have to consider the biggest power, because this biggest power dominates the smallest power. x to the power 3 is much bigger than x to the power 2 when x become larger and larger. Okay, so if you just consider the 3x to the power 4, the limit of x goes to a positive infinity. Okay, this is even. That means this will become infinite, positive infinity, no matter the x goes to a positive or negative infinity. Okay, how about the qx? Well, you can see this is power 3, which is an odd number. Okay, so what is the value of x goes to infinity? Well, you can substitute x goes to infinity in this case. What you can find is, if you substitute x equal to infinity, this will become very large times a negative number, then this will become a negative infinity value. Okay. Next, if this x goes to negative infinity and this becomes very negative times the negative value, and this becomes positive infinity. So this is the way for you to deal with this kind of questions. So sometimes they will ask you to evaluate the n behavior. That means what will be the result when n goes to very large. For example, when x goes to positive infinity, will it explode to infinity, decrease to negative infinity, or equal to zero, stay at a steady state? Again, you just have to consider the biggest power one. Okay, for example, for the fx, just consider when x goes to infinity. Okay, so for the numerator, 3x plus 2, the biggest power is just 1. For the denominator, the biggest power is 2. So the denominator will dominate the numerator. Therefore, when x becomes greater and greater, you can ignore the numerator, just consider the denominator, where the denominator is bigger and bigger. This is just equal to 1 over x, this one, right? So when x becomes bigger and bigger, this will go to 0. For the second one, gx. Well, for the numerator, the biggest power is 4. The denominator, the bigger power is also 4. Therefore, if you just consider the biggest power, you can regard it as 40x to the power 4 divided by 10x to the power 4. Okay, what will it become? Okay, the x to the power 4 can be cancelled. 40 divided by 1 is just 4. Therefore, the limit of x goes to infinity for this function is exactly 4. Finally, the last one, x to the power 3, the biggest power, derived by 2x, the biggest power for the denominator. You can clearly see that the biggest power dominates the numerator, dominates the denominator, and the value can be expressed as x to the power 3 derived by 2x, which is equal to x squared derived by 2. Okay, therefore the limit of x goes to infinity is just positive infinity. So this is the last part of the limit. Well, actually in mathematics you still learn a very important concept after the limit is called continuity. I'm not going to talk about continuity because this is a very important concept you have to know. Therefore, I strongly encourage to grab your mathematics textbook to review the concept of continuity. After that, you can take a look of the topic of the derivative, differentiation, and the application of the differentiations.